Children diagnosed with autism spectrum disorder have qualitative impairments in social behavior. And it's important that behavior analysts and therapists and teachers, parents, work on improving these social skills. When children have appropriate social skills, they're more likely to have friends, meaningful relationships. And when children don't have social skills, it can lead to some pretty negative outcomes like depression, loneliness, thoughts of suicide, and those kind of behaviors that we don't want to see with the clients that we work with. One way to address these deficits in social skills is to provide behavioral intervention. And a behavior intervention that we provide at Autism Partnership are social skills groups. Social skills groups are opportunities for children to come together to simultaneously learn a variety of social behaviors, such as joining in, talking to friends, joint attention, sharing, what makes a friend. And these, they come and they systematically learn a variety of social behaviors over time. We've been fortunate enough to do some research on the effectiveness of social skills groups for children with autism and found that they're a really effective intervention in improving social behavior and improving meaningful relationships. One study that my colleagues and I did back at Autism Partnership in the United States was a study that we refer to as the Penguin Study. In the Penguin Study, we brought 15 children together who never received intervention before and taught them a variety of social behaviors over 32 sessions, so about 64 hours of intervention. And what we found is prior to intervention, they had very little social behavior, and following intervention, they showed great improvements in their social behaviors. And these improvements maintained 32 weeks after the study had concluded. Today, from what I've gathered from talking to some of the parents in that study, they're still friends with each other. They're still hanging out. They're still going trick-or-treating during Halloween. So the effects of social skills groups can be life-changing for individuals diagnosed with autism. Another area of research and that we've done in clinical practice is a procedure called the teacher interaction procedure, which really works on teaching more advanced social behaviors to individuals diagnosed with autism and other disorders. The teaching interaction procedure really came from the University of Kansas, where it was first implemented with juvenile delinquents, and then it's been brought and it's been used at Autism Partnership for some time. In this procedure, we really focus on teaching children why they should be displaying appropriate social behavior. So looking at why they should be joining in, why they should be sharing their toys, why they should be talking to their friends, and why it's important to have meaningful relationships. We've seen in clinical practice for years that when we implement this procedure to a high degree of fidelity, that children are learning a vast array of social behaviors. And we've seen in our research that it's a highly effective procedure and much more effective than some of the other procedures that are out there that claim to improve social behavior but have really no evidence to support them. So it's a great way to teach children diagnosed with autism or any child how to engage in appropriate social behaviors. Another procedure that was commonly implemented that we've done both clinically and in the research is a procedure called the cool versus not cool procedure. And here you're just discriminating between appropriate behavior and inappropriate behavior. So the teacher would demonstrate a behavior that's cool, maybe winning graciously, and then also demonstrate a behavior that's not cool, so losing graciously. So if you're playing a game and you win, you say, you know, good game, or you know, you shake the other person's hand, and if you're doing it the not appropriate way, the not cool way, then maybe you're gloating, you're bragging. So really looking at that social discrimination. And the fun part of it is that the child gets to practice. So after the teacher demonstrates the social behavior, the child goes and practices the behavior with the teacher. And when done correctly, you can then generalize it into different settings. You can do it with their peers, you can do it in the school, you can do it in the home, you can do it in the community. It is just a really fun procedure that's highly effective also in increasing social behavior. And then the last really procedure that we use quite a bit is just peer shaping. We're just constantly reinforcing approximations of social behavior and really embedding instruction throughout the environment to increase and improve their social behavior. And we've done this in a variety of ways. One of my favorite ways I've seen is a game called Fruit Salad, where you have kids on sitting across from each other, and you assign each of them a fruit. So one kid's a banana, another kid's an orange, another kid's an apple, and then as you call their fruit, they have to go in the middle and high five or do something that's a social kind of engagement. And then at the end, you call fruit salad and everyone comes in. So it's just another fun way, really, to work on social behavior for individuals with autism.